Welcome to this next video for Unreal Engine 4 New Users Part 8, where we'll be continuing doing our level design for New Users Part 8. And here we'll be ending level brush creation. Here in the geometry with the box and all the stuff, and I will begin to place some static mesh to show you how to rearrange static meshes on the content browser. So I will go to the content browser, and I have on the props, I have some basic stuff here that I can drag and drop, like this frame. I can drag and drop this frame, and you see that it won't fit, but I can make it fit. All I need to do is use the basic tools. Solamente puedo utilizar para hacer que este marco de la puerta quepa aquí. Solamente voy a utilizar la herramienta básica. Mira, aquí lo pongo pequeñito. Not that much. I will change my scale options up here. Great. Right there. Now I make it bigger. A little bit. And a little bit smaller in the X axis. Now I have a frame. And I can copy that frame. I rotate it. I'm having it in this order. This other doorway, ¿verdad? Ponerlo en el otro boquete para la puerta. Un poquito para afuera. Now we're good to go, ¿verdad? Ahora estamos ready. Tengo ahí unos frames. Oh, la otra puerta también. Copio para acá. Acuérdense que estoy copiando con alternate, and then when I move, it make a copy, okay? When I hit alternate and I move, it will do a copy. Now I can have this window frame right here. Those are static mesh. I'm just teaching how to use Unreal Engine. On the next videos, I will be teaching how to use 3ds Max to create static meshes that you can put in here. Okay. Now I have a nice window frame. And I copy this window frame and copy it again. Nice and neat. Aquí está, lo copié, lo escalé. Yo sé que ustedes, la gente que habla español, sabe inglés también. Son más los que hablan español que saben inglés que los que hablan inglés que saben español. Ahora voy a chequear este aquí. Tengo un boquetito ahí, lo voy a arreglar. Ahí está. Degrees, 90 grados. Pongo aquí otra vez. Entonces, if I scale this, you see how the frames scale up too. So I will make this one smaller like this, and I will have something cool. I will copy this, copy it again. And then select both and copy again. And now I can select all of them and then scale them. But you see how they are scaling one by one. I don't want that. I want them to scale uniformly. Want them all to scale up. This scale option just work on local. I teach you later how to scale this all four at once, okay? As a group. Now I will have this wall selected, go to geometry mode, select this face. If I can select that face, I will go to the orthographic views. I will select those two vertex here. Move it away. Select the other two and move it away. And now we have a nice window opening with some frames over there. And as you can see how this is taking some form, looking good. I need to fix these window frames. They look nice, don't worry. Okay, now I will have some lining in here. We have a light here, you see, I just hit rotation and rotate it 90 degrees and I have a nice... If you press the backslash key, you can know how tall is your level. That cube with some spheres, ¿verdad? Ese cubo con esa esfera es más o menos la altura de una persona, así que más o menos ahí está bien ese. Copio para acá. Then I can have a roof. It is the other way. I can hit go to detail. Sorry, I can hit right click, go to transform and mirror on C, and it is now looking downwards. And you can measure it. You see? Now I can put it smaller. Content browser, put it in here, right click, transform, mirror, repeat more, then 1, 2, 3, 4, I don't know. And 1, 2, 3, 4, right there we have something. Let's delete that crap, man. Let's have table here and let's have that lamp. Over here, and let's have some shares here, and let's copy this chair. You know how to copy already. If not, you can rotate it. pressing alternate and you will have a copy. Let's put that copy here. And let's have another one. Let's rotate it that way. Nice and neat. And you see how this level is taking form. So let's end this video. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Gracias por ver este video. Entreténganse. Entertain yourself dragging and dropping stuff from the content browser. Later, I will show you how to have stuff in your content browser from 3ds Max. Okay? So let's end this video.